एवरीवन, टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट आर्टीरियल ब्लड प्रेशर। ब्लड प्रेशर इज द लेटरल प्रेशर एक्सर्टेड बाय मूविंग कॉलम ऑफ ब्लड ऑन द ब्लड वेसल वॉल। मैक्सिमम एंड मिनिमम प्रेशर्स इन द आर्टीरियल सिस्टम आर नोन एज सिस्टोलिक एंड डायस्टोलिक प्रेशर्स रिस्पेक्टिवली। द इंस्ट्रूमेंट कॉमनली यूज्ड फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ब्लड प्रेशर इज स्फिग्मोमैनोमीटर। स्फिग्मोमैनोमीटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ an inflatable flat rubber bag covered by a non-distensible cloth envelope called Riva Rocky cuff. The cavity of the bag is connected by a long rubber tube to a manometer and by a short rubber tube to rubber pump. A small valve is provided between the pump and the bag, which permits the escape of air and reduction of the pressure when required. The manometer is a U-shaped tube, one limb being broader than the other. The broader limb is the reservoir for mercury, and the narrow limb is graduated from 0 to 300 millimeter, with the smallest division corresponding to a reading of 2 mm of mercury. Inflatable bag dimensions. Length to width ratio is 2:1. Therefore, wider cuff should be used to record blood pressure in obese individual and in lower limbs, and small cuffs should be used to record blood pressure in children. During blood pressure measurement, following precautions are required. The subject should be given at least few minutes rest. No tight clothing is advisable. The arm of the subject should be completely exposed and kept at heart level. Keep the cuff at heart level of the subject. While tying the cuff, please take care middle of the inflatable bag should be just above the brachial artery. The cuff should neither be too tight nor be too loose. This way we can tie the cuff. The initial mercury mark must be at zero. Inflate the cuff in between measurements to avoid venous congestion. Procedure: apply the cuff as we have described to the arm with the middle of the cuff over the inner side of the arm with its low edge 2 cm above the elbow. Starting with palpatory method, palpate the radial pulse. Inflate the bag gradually till the pulse at wrist disappears. Then deflate the cuff very slowly and note the pressure at which first pulsation appears over the radial artery. This is systolic blood pressure. So by palpatory method, we can get the rough idea of systolic blood pressure. Advantage of palpatory method: auscultatory gap, if present, is not missed in the auscultatory method when blood pressure is recorded by palpatory method before auscultatory method. Next is auscultatory method. Apply the stethoscope lightly over the brachial artery located by palpation. Now, inflate the cuff to few millimeter of mercury above the pressure observed by palpatory method. Then deflate it slowly and listen to the appearance of a series of sounds known as Korotkov sounds. The pressure at which the sound appears is the point of systolic pressure, and the point at which sound muffles or disappears is the measure of diastolic blood pressure. Korotkov sounds. When the pressure in the cuff is progressively lowered, the sounds undergo a series of changes in their quality and intensity. They are heard in four different phases. These sounds are known as Korotkov sounds. Appearance of faint tapping sound is recorded as systolic blood pressure. As you lower down the mercury column, gradually the sound becomes murmurish. Then it becomes loud and clear sound, and then it becomes muffled and finally disappears. Disappearance of the sound is known as diastolic blood pressure.